हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू द चैनल साइकोटेक। दिस वीडियो विल बी पार्ट टू ऑफ VSMS वीडियो। इन पार्ट वन आई हैड डिस्कस्ड अबाउट टाइटल ऑफ द प्रैक्टिकल, एम्स एंड ऑब्जेक्टिव ऑफ द VSMS, इंट्रोडक्शन विच इंक्लूड्स हिस्टोरिकल बैकग्राउंड ऑफ द टेस्ट, सोशल मैच्योरिटी, सोशल एज, सोशल कोशेंट एंड सोशल एरियाज, which further includes social help general, self-help eating, self-help dressing, self-direction, occupation, communication, locomotion and socialization. And beyond that, I had also discussed about description of the test, materials required and participants profile. If you haven't watched the part 1 of VSMS video, you can find the link in description. You can click on the link and watch part 1 of the video. So, in part 2 of this video, I will be discussing about procedure of the test, administration of VSMS, recording, scoring of the test, discussion, conclusion, and references. First of all, let us discuss about procedure and administration. In procedure and administration, further we have some subheadings like preparation, report, instructions, precautions and introspective report. In preparations, you have to mention that the materials required for the conduction of the test, like test booklet, answer sheet, pencil, eraser, stopwatch, are kept ready before starting the procedure. Next we have report. You have to mention that report was created with the participant and he or she was well informed about the details of the test. In instruction part, you have to mention that you have given all the details and instructions regarding the test before starting the procedure. In precautions, you have to mention the precautions, if any, to be considered while administering the test. In introspective report, you have to mention the introspective report which is given by the participant after completion of the test by the participant. An introspective report is to be taken, that is the participant's feeling and constraints faced by him or her while undergoing the test is mentioned under this subheading in first person in the verbatim manner as the participant has mentioned in the report. You have to just copy and paste under this heading. Always remember, the administration of the test needs to be carried out in a semi-structured informal atmosphere by having the mother or parents along with the child or having the child alone depending upon the demand made by the items. It is preferable to request mothers to keep silent and not participate in the testing situation, but just to provide security to the child by being present. So now let's look at the recording part, how to record the responses. To record the responses, you have to use the record sheet for noting the child responses. Items should be scored strictly upon the performances of the task. And for scoring, child is asked to perform a specific task. Each item in the booklet is to be scored on a 3-point scale. First is, you have to mark the item pass, that is you can tick in front of the or before the statement if the child is able to perform correctly, and a score of +1 is to be given to the choice always in the case of positive behavior. And next is half credit. Half credit may be given if it can be presumed that the child could have passed the item if the opportunity was present. The choice, sometimes, and other wordings indicating the middle path is to be given a score of 0.5. Here, you have to remember that these half credits receive full credit if they lie between two passed items. Mark the item fail, that is, you have to mention cross if the child is not able to perform correct. And the last choice, which denotes the least expression of the positive behavior, is to be given a score of 0. For example, there are 5 statements. You can see here, number 57 child is able to perform this task. So we have to mention, that's why this statement is being ticked right and given plus one for this statement. And likewise in 58, plus one as the participant can perform this task. And next statement 59, the participant cannot perform, so this statement is being marked wrong and the credit is given as zero. For next item, that is 60, 0.5 has been given because the participant can perform this task sometimes, not always. Likewise, you can score and you can record the answer sheet. While recording the responses, always remember, for example, if the child is of 5 years, so try to start from statement 1, means item 1, till you receive all the responses wrong or maximum responses wrong. If participant can respond to more items which are beyond his or her age, like if the child is of 5 years and he can respond the statements or items which are given under the category of 6, 7, 8 years, so you can record all those responses as well, and you have to consider while recording. But when the participant start giving maximum wrong responses, then you have to stop there. Next is scoring. How to score the responses which are given by the participants. For scoring, add up past scores, whether it is full and half. Then find out the social age, that is SA, from appendix 2. You can find appendix 2 in the VSMS manual. For example, if the total score is 30, then you can check social age in corresponding to score 30. Likewise, you can see in this table, for score 30, social age is given as 1.77. Likewise, for score 40, the social age is given 2.6. So you have to use this social age while calculating social quotient. Now, next is to compute social quotient by dividing social age by chronological age and multiplying by 100. So SQ is equal to social age divided by chronological age into 100. Then you have to assess maturity level both in terms of social age and social quotient for each of the 8 social areas by referring VSMS norms, and enter in the columns of social maturity constellation record. After scoring, next part is discussion. In discussion part, you have to discuss the result based on the interpretation. It may be further analyzed in the light of introspective report. Then conclusion. Under this heading, you have to conclude the findings of the test, like social maturity, social age, social quotient, and the social areas, which further includes 8 sub areas, that is self-help general, self-help eating, self-help dressing, self-direction, occupation, communication, locomotion, and socialization. You have to clearly conclude what were the scores for these areas, and you have to write the result under the conclusion heading. Also, you can give the suggestions, if any, under this conclusions heading. At last, you have to write the references which you have referred to, like books, websites, manuals, to perform the test. But always remember, references are to be mentioned in APA format and should be alphabetically listed. I hope ye video aapke liye useful raha. If you are new to this channel and you haven't subscribed to the channel yet, please subscribe to the channel, like the video, and press the bell icon so that you can receive all the notifications on time. Thank you.